In this lesson, we're going to talk about nephrotic syndrome. Now, this is a condition that affects the nephron in the kidneys. And if you remember from anatomy, the nephron is the functional unit of the kidneys. This is where the kidneys do all their major work. So if it's not working properly, a lot can go wrong. So nephrotic syndrome is a disease of the kidneys that is specifically characterized by a loss of plasma proteins into the urine. Now, normally proteins are too large to escape out of the capillaries and the glomerulus, but we'll look in a second how the proteins are actually able to escape out into the urine. And so that leads to proteinuria and hypoalbuminemia. So this protein is increased in the urine, but it's decreased in the blood. So that decreased protein level now in the bloodstream is going to lead to massive edema. Now you can see this is a nephrotic syndrome patient who is having severe facial edema from nephrotic syndrome. Now anything that can cause damage to the kidneys and the nephrons, and especially to the glomerulus, can actually lead to nephrotic syndrome. So this could be diabetes. Remember, it's a vascular disorder. It's very hard on the vessels. Or lupus, which is an autoimmune inflammatory response that can cause a lot of damage to the kidneys. And then, of course, glomerulonephritis, which we'll talk about in its own lesson, can cause damage to the glomerulus. So let's quickly explore, why does a loss of protein into the urine cause edema in the body? Well, remember we have something called oncotic pressure. And oncotic pressure is controlled by proteins. And I remember it this way, protein pulls. So when we have protein here in the bloodstream, it's going to pull and hold all of this fluid inside of the vessels and the capillaries. It's like a magnet. So when the patient has nephrotic syndrome, they're going to dump the protein into the urine, but other kidney mechanisms like diffusion are going to keep the water and the fluid in the system. So now we've lost the protein in the bloodstream, so we no longer have it here to hold this fluid in, but we still have all the fluid. So if there's no protein to be that magnet, all that fluid is going to start leaking out of the capillaries into the tissues. So the less protein here in the vessels means more fluid leaking out of the capillaries and into the tissues, causing this massive edema. So what are we going to see? Well, again, more than anything, we're going to see this severe edema. It could be peripheral edema like you see here. This is specifically pitting edema. But these patients can also experience pulmonary edema. So you'll hear things like crackles, or you may see that frothy sputum. We talked a lot about pulmonary edema in the cardiac course. Now you're also going to see weight gain because they're gaining all of this fluid into their system. And then things like signs of renal failure, like azotemia, which is increased nitrogenous waste products. So you'll see an increased BUN, increased creatinine. You could also see electrolyte abnormalities because this kidney is not working like it's supposed to. Now, patients are going to be fatigued from all of this. I mean, imagine how you can feel with all of this extra fluid on you. Now, females, especially younger girls, are going to experience amenorrhea as a result of this protein shift. That's a decrease or an absence of menses. And then finally, we're going to see a positive renal biopsy when they test the kidneys for nephrotic syndrome. Our goal for these patients is to reduce the amount of protein excreted and reduce the edema in the patient's system. And of course, we want to minimize any further complications. They could have respiratory distress because of all the fluid on their lungs. And then they could also get permanent kidney damage. So we want to make sure that we're protecting their system. So first things first, we're going to identify and treat the cause, especially if this is an infectious source. We want to make sure we're giving IV antibiotics and we're treating that infection so that we can reverse it and prevent that significant renal damage. We're going to put the patient on a low sodium diet to decrease that fluid retention and keep it from spiraling out of control even more. Same thing with balancing protein. Now, some people used to say we wanted to give them high protein so they had more protein in their vessels, but studies have shown that actually it just leaks out even more. So all we want to do here is make sure that they have a balanced level of protein and that they're getting enough protein in their diet as opposed to not enough. So our goal for them is going to be for them to have at least 1 gram of protein per kilogram of body weight per day. So again, we don't necessarily want excess protein, but we've got to make sure they're at least getting enough. And then, of course, we'll give diuretics to get some of the fluid out and off their system, especially off their lungs, to relieve some of those symptoms. So our top priority concepts for a patient with nephrotic syndrome are obviously fluid and electrolytes, a lot of edema, elimination because of the kidney function, but also immunology. We know that some sort of infection or immune process or possibly even diabetes is causing this protein shift. So we want to assess for infection and address whatever the cause is. Make sure you check out the care plan attached to this lesson to see more detailed nursing interventions and rationales. So let's recap. Nephrotic syndrome is a condition of damage in the kidneys characterized by a loss of protein into the urine. And that loss of protein is going to cause fluid to leak into the tissues and lead to this massive edema. This could be peripheral. This could be pulmonary. It just depends on where the fluid begins to leak out. They could see it everywhere. We want to identify and treat the cause, especially if it was infectious, because that's something we can reverse. We're going to give diuretics to get the fluid off, and we're going to replace protein and just make sure that they're getting enough protein in their diet. And our goal is just to stop that protein loss, get the fluid off, and prevent any further complications like respiratory distress or severe permanent renal damage. So that's it for nephrotic syndrome. Make sure you check out the resources attached to this lesson to learn more. Now go out and be your best selves today. And as always, happy nursing.